January, Fed Chairman Jerome Powell seemed to indicate that, as she pointed out, that no matter what the president keeps saying about him, when it comes to this trade fallout, he's got the president's back, even if the president keeps hitting him slightly below the back.
We would never comment on trade policy. We don't do trade. It's not a responsibility of the Fed. But I think it is the case that uncertainty around trade policy is causing some companies to hold back now on investment. And so our obligation is to use our tools to support the economy.
All right, well, got the market's attention. We will act as appropriate. How many times have you heard that from this Federal Reserve? Do whatever it takes to sort of backstop the economy, deal with it. It is hell to pay for all of this trade back and forth. We've got Lizzie Wick and Nick Donald with us. Also a very good read of these markets. Melissa Armo. I think, Melissa, what the Fed was making clear, no matter the back and forth between us and the White House, the fact of the matter is we're here to, you know, support if things go bad, right?
Right, which is a good sign. So I'm not really sure why Trump is upset at the Fed chairman right now at this point, except for the fact that this number came out today. But you know what? Every single economic number that comes out cannot blow it out of the water. And it has. It almost has when you look back. So now people are getting used to it. So if something just goes a little bit shy of being perfect, then everybody is all up in arms and they're back talking to recession again, and rates have to be cut 0.5%.
Yeah, what I was just trying to look up as you were speaking there, what the president tweeted just today, that the Fed should lower rates, Lizzie. They were way too early to raise, way too late to cut, and a big dose of quantitative tightening didn't help matters any. Where did I find this guy, Jerome? Well, you can't win them all.
He's pretty blunt, right?
Yeah.
That's our president.
Not a fan, I guess.
Not a fan. You could put him in that category. There's debate about that, about what the president's saying. Do we want to go into negative yield territory like Europe, flattening growth? Naturally, the GDP growth will go down when inflation goes down. It costs less to buy things for companies and businesses and people. I hear what the president is saying. However, you know, a strong dollar does draw an investment into the U.S. Capital investment has been slow here. What we also didn't like in that job number was the number of government workers.
Without the census workers,
it would have been lower.
Explore that a little bit, because it was still a good jobs report. I want to posit that we're still at 3.7% unemployment rate. We added 130,000 jobs. I guess they were expecting 150,000 or more. The fact of the matter is, though, Melissa, we are down from the pace we were establishing last year. Does it worry you that, we're not going into reverse, but it's slowing?
No, it doesn't worry me at all. When you look at companies, we recently had earnings with Target and Lulu reported. They made brand new all-time highs, and it's so unusual for retailers like that to make brand new highs before the holiday season. Usually they lag, and that's why they call it Black Friday. They go into the black at the end of the year.
Right? That's something you watch closely, right?
Yeah, that's right. Melissa's absolutely right. You don't have a recession when wage growth is strong or job growth is pretty solid and labor force participation is solid and the jobless rate is at 50-year lows. You never, hardly ever have a recession with those good numbers. The question is, how will the trade deal be settled? Will the president say, you know what, this is a stalemate? It ain't going to get any better. We know multinationals are leaving China. The president.
Well, is the answer to that then, Lizzie? The consensus is they're going to cut next later on this month
for the Fed. Yeah,
for the Fed, a quarter point, maybe more to come. Is that what you're buying?
Well, you know, the Fed can't carry it all.
No.
And you're absolutely right. There is a slowdown. You look at agricultural exports to China plummeting from $24 billion to $1 billion. The farm bill is hurting. The president can easily plant a flag, declare victory. He's the only president who's really taken this on full force. And he was right to do it. Critics say on Wall Street that he was absolutely in the right to do it. No rational person can think it's normal for any country to take half another country's
IP. I don't want to get into a trade argument with you, but I do want to know, Melissa, do you think that what's going on here is something the economy can weather if we don't get a settlement or some sort of a deal before the election? Because the message coming from the Federal Reserve was, to Lizzie's point, we're going to do what we can, but we can't go nuts here.
Yeah, I think the economy can weather it for two reasons. One, people are working, and you can tell that because they're spending money. And two, the corporate tax cuts really helped companies. So even though they are
These are the same companies, though, that are sort of drawing back from their hiring.
Well, yeah, because, of course, they don't. Exactly. But
I knew it was a stupid question.
They saved money, with the tax cuts. But when you look about it, what do you think? 40 years ago, In China, they're like a city like Shanghai, people didn't have heat. They didn't have electricity. I mean, China grew like poof, like that in 40 years. And why? Because a lot of U.S. companies moved manufacturing to China. And a lot of people may not know
that. And that might be unwinding.
Right. And a lot of people may not know this, but when you're over there, they actually pay for 3 meals a day and housing. And so the people that work there, the Chinese, they may get a low wage, but they companies provide housing and meals for them. So, you know, you can't have it both ways. These companies have benefited by the low wages and also not paying health insurance and all this stuff.
Got it. All right, ladies, I want to thank you both very, very much. Now to Dorian, down to a